I'm gonna beat the pussy up, because I'm Alan Barker. I like beating up pussy.
I hate that song. This song makes my penis soft.
I'm Alan Barker, I like to beat up penis. I mean, I shouldn't say these things. I don't know what you're talking about over there. I don't know what you're talking about over there.
Did Mike ever get in and caught you last night?
I don't know. And at some point, it's just like, Jesus, why do we care? I shouldn't say these things about him. He called me and was being all Mike game-ish.
Son!
I'm like, Jesus Christ.
Once there was this girl.
Came in at 100. I'll probably get them for $20 on a Tuesday.
Probably.
Who's that?
The Crash Test Dummies guys, the guys.
Guess what I heard the other day? Blind Melon Jelly. You know what I'm talking about?
Blind Melon was the shit back in the day.
Right.
Did that main singer die?
My guilty pleasure song is Titanium.
Okay, let me get our little friend on the line here.
Who are we doing today?
We got Shark Boy up first.
Who is that?
He is a professional wrestler who does an impeccable Stone Cold Steve Austin impression.
Does he know Bud Doobie?
We'll ask him.
Who?
Bud Doobie.
No.
We'll ask Bud Doobie. See if he knows Bud Doobie. Bud Doobie!
What? He was this guy who was on, Locked Up, and then he got out and he started wrestling.
Hey, is this Shark Boy?
Bud Doobie.
This is Shark Boy.
Hey, buddy, what's going on? We're going to go on the air here in a couple minutes. I'm going to feed you through the system. We'll get you on.
Okay, sounds good.
All right, brother, be right back with you.
So, Bud Doobie.
He didn't sound like Austin.
He was in prison. He had to join the prison.
What's that all about?
He was in there sometimes. He's doing some.
The Jiggy Jaguar Experience. Here is Jiggy Jaguar.
It is the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Experience, coast to coast and corner to border. JiggyJaguar.com, JiggyJaguar.net. I got my man Israel in the building.
Yo, it's your boy Israel, the man West Mogul in the making.
He is, of course, one of those old-fashioned.
And we got too damn many urban thugs. Yo.
And we got Kevin Chris with us in the building today, yeah. Because he is excited as punch for our first our first guest. We also have Jennifer, the local hood rat, in the building. And Steve Capella from Capella Music will be on the line very soon. He will be coming in to say hello to us. And we might have an appearance from Sean Story, probably not. But we're also going to talk to my good, close, personal, longtime friend, Mr. Ryan Stevenson from the Cotillion Ballroom here in the great city of Wichita, Kansas. But our first guest, hopefully he's on the line, hopefully he can hear me, hopefully it's we're getting it in where we fit in and all that stuff that the rappers say. I think we have Shark Boy on the line. Are you there, sir?
Hey, guys.
You can hear me.
I'm
look
here.
At that. Awesome. Now Shark Boy, what are you up to today, my friend? I know, do you have a show this afternoon or what's going on, my man?
Nope, nothing like that. It's I don't know if they told you guys about the NFL started today. Well, started Thursday, but yeah,
amen,
my team's
amen.
On right now. I'm watching the Bengals and the Bears play right now.
The Bengals and the Bears. Now, of course, I love the Bears.
You do not.
I love Jay Cutler.
You don't know.
I'm trying to figure out how that. Bears. I'm trying to figure out how that bodybuilder got on the field. For the Bears. At least he gets that joke.
Yeah.
I'm glad.
Yeah, you got that. No one else did.
No one else did. But Shark Boy, what have you been up to lately? What's been going on? I know that we haven't seen you on TV in a while. I know you were on one of those one-night pay-per-views that the good old folks at TNA Wrestling put together. But what's been going on, man?
You know, still doing independent wrestling. A lot of stuff in the Midwest. That's where I'm located, in Ohio, and I've been doing a lot of stuff around here. If it ain't on TV, it's like it doesn't happen. So a lot of people don't even realize that I'm, you know, still actively participating in the wrestling world, and that's, you know, I've been doing this for 16 years now, and I've always been kind of a journeyman independent wrestler, you know, and I'm still hacking away at it, man.
We've got Sharkboy with us today here on Radio Xenu, also TalkRadioX.com. We've got Cousin Chris in the building, the big superstar. We got Israel in the building, my man. He's out there hoofing the streets and selling CDs and making it happen. And then, of course, we have over there on the couch our lovely, lovely hood rat friend. If you want to get more information on what we're doing, watch live video, all that crap, go to JiggyJaguar.net. And Radio Xenu and Talk Radio X, if you want to listen to the audio, you can also download our app, Radio Loyalty. We just posted that on Twitter and Facebook. You can download that and say hello to us. Now, Sharkboy, me and Chris used to get into an argument about about you. he believes... Well, go ahead. Jump in there.
I thought you were Garrett Bischoff. I'm so sorry. That's an insult to you, probably, because you're a way better wrestler than Garrett Bischoff.
Garrett Bischoff's a little thicker than I am.
Well, maybe. You still suck. You're better. And when are we going to see a feud between you and Stone Cold E.T.?
Yeah, when are we going to see a feud between Sharkboy and Stone Cold E.T.?
Well, I would be up for that. That's some entertaining stuff, man. I've watched him, you know, go through the drive-through restaurants and mess with the people. That's really entertaining stuff. I think he's hilarious. I actually got a voicemail from him in the middle of the night. Jimmy Yang was on a show with him out in New York, and he left me a voicemail in the middle of the night where he told me he didn't appreciate me doing an impression of him. It was really great.
That is awesome.
Do you like Christmas donuts like he does?
Yes.
I got the money.
Yeah.
He does.
That that's like my favorite one.
they could have a Christmas donut on a pole match.
There you go.
Has the real
that's
Stone Cold Steve Austin
right there.
Emailed just like, stop doing my shit.
Yeah. Has Austin ever got a hold of you and said, hey, you know,
That's my shit.
Stop doing me, son.
It's exactly the opposite, actually. He's actually been super supportive of it. He said things on Twitter. He said things in interviews about how he's entertained by it, and he thinks it's funny. So he said, I think the last thing he tweeted was, brother's got to eat or something, you know. Like he realizes
that. Did he say brother's got to eat?
Brother's got to eat. Like, this is part of my thing now, you know what I mean? This is what I'm doing with the character, and he enjoys it. So I'm really thankful for that. I mean, he's obviously a great guy.
Hey, you know what? He's not doing nothing. You guys get together and make a faction, Stone Cold Steve Austin faction. Have E.T., you, and him go after beating everybody up.
Yeah, I watched that.
Drinking beer and eating Christmas donuts.
And Reese Pieces.
Yeah.
Now,
that's good TV.
You have been, since you've been on the independent circuit, what do people think of the Sharkboy character still? People know you, people, you know, having a good time with you and everything, or
For the most part, people remember it. People are incredibly supportive. I still get a great reaction when I come out, and fans are still seem to be really interested in watching the character and watching me perform. And, you know, I'm just really lucky and grateful. I think I have some of the best fans in the world. I really do. They've always been supportive of me, and they remember me. So that's a huge thing, because when you're off TV for a while, people have a tendency to forget, but my fans just haven't forgot about it, and that's great.
Well, you know, you need to be going to ROH or PWG or something, man. It'd be awesome seeing you in those federations, stunning people.
Yeah, that's two groups that I've never worked for, and I've worked for just about everybody. So, yeah, it would be great to get an opportunity with one or both of those groups. I would enjoy doing that.
Hey, I just made a WrestleMania match, a 6-man tag, Stone Cold Steve Austin, Sharkboy and Stone Cold E.T. versus Goldberg, Gilbert, and Ryback. That'd be awesome.
Those three guys on the other side are too similar.
I like my wrestling more tits, I'll be honest.
We need the women in there. We got it.
How you doing, Shark Boy? I'm the resident perv on the show. So,
right on, man.
I ask all the important questions.
Go.
How many of the wrestling girls do you get to bang? Is that part of your character?
Oh, my God.
Is that, like, in the contract, or how does that work?
Yes, it's in my contract. I get a minimum number per year.
Oh, wow.
That's pretty cool.
That's awesome. Do you deal with your mask on?
Be real.
Yeah, do you use the mask or what?
No, you know what, man? I'll be totally honest. I tried that one time, and it was so ridiculous. I said I'd never want to do this.
I respect your honesty.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Now, I got to ask you a question.
Okay.
Have you heard of a wrestler named Bud Doobie?
Who?
Bud Doobie. No, haven't.
See?
Oh, my God. You guys don't watch Locked Up?
Nobody watches but you, man.
On MSNBC.
Yeah, there's this guy named, he was, I guess, locked up in Colorado, and he wrestles, too, and he came up with the name Bud Doobie, and his whole character is that he smokes pot. So that's what kind of intrigues me, but he's racist, too. So I don't know how to feel about that.
Nobody's perfect, right?
Yeah, I mean, but it's kind of oxymoron, because when you're high, you're too high to be racist. And everyone knows that.
You would think. Yeah. You would think.
I mean, you know, when you're high, not that you're I high have been. Racist. I'm just saying.
Yeah, right.
Don't judge me, Chris. What is your favorite thing about.
I don't know who he is.
Oh, well, I guess he's not important.
He is.
Sorry, Bud Doobie. I try. So, what is the best thing about your job, and what wrestlers inspired you? Like, I had nightmares that the Ultimate Warrior kicked my ass as a kid. You know, like, as a black kid growing up in the hood, that was the most scariest shit ever. This big ass white guy who's shaking every fucking thing, chasing you. That's pretty scary shit. But he's also my favorite wrestler of all times. That guy's still huge.
I don't know that any wrestlers ever really gave me nightmares. A few promoters have.
I can understand.
Tina.
Yeah, but I was a big fan of the Macho Man Randy Savage.
Oh, yeah. Macho Man.
He was my favorite. Brian Pillman, a fellow Cincinnatian, I really looked up to Brian Pillman. Even back when he was Flying Brian, he wore the Bengals trucks, and then when he became the Loose Cannon, that was fabulous. The Hollywood Blondes, of course, with Steve Austin, that was great. And Ric Flair, definitely Ric Flair. I can just remember going to see him live a whole bunch of times, and watching him on TV, and always finding a way to escape with the title. And whenever he lost the title, he'd win it back a week later. I mean, there was, how could you not? You know, at the time, I hated the guy, but looking back on it, I really actually just, you know, loved watching him work. And there's, whenever I go back and watch his like best of stuff, it's always like that's the best stuff I own probably is Flair.
Why did Ric Flair ever ask you to pay his bar tab when you were in TNA?
It's Shark Boy.
He knows I don't carry that kind of cash.
Now, I'm
somebody pay me. Woo!
That's right. You are such a cool guy, and one thing that I've always wondered, and I was watching the recent Vince Russo timeline that came out, and he brought this up. And I've always wondered why this is, and you're one of these guys that's never done this. So maybe you'll be able to answer this, maybe you won't be able to, but why is it that guys in the business, whether they are, you know, in TNA, WWE, ROH, wherever, they're there, and everybody's buddies, and then when they leave, they trash everybody. I've never heard you ever trash any of your former employers or fellow wrestlers or anything.
Not even an ex-girlfriend.
Why do they feel like they gotta trash people when they leave?
I don't know. I think for some guys, maybe it's the opportunity to stay relevant. When you say negative things, you get a lot more attention. I remember I did a... I did it one of those shoot interviews one time on video, and the guy says, "We're going to film you without your mask." I said, "Stop right there. I'm wearing the mask. Well, no, but this is a shoot video. So, no, I mean, yeah, I want to protect the character. I'm going to wear the mask. Okay, we can wear the mask. We're going to ask you about, you know, some really controversial people. We're going to ask you about Jeff Jarrett and Triple H and Vince McMahon, and we really want to know what you... I said, okay, man, but I'm going to tell you right now, it's going to be the most boring shoot interview that you've ever done, because I'm not going to sit there and say bad things about guys that I respect, you know? And so I think people do have a tendency to do that. They go negative, and that way you get more attention, you remain relevant, or maybe just they couldn't say anything while they were under contract, and so... You know, that's what they do when they have the freedom to say it. I guess they say those things, but I just have too much respect for the groups that I've worked for and the guys that I've worked with, and I don't think, you know, it would have to be something pretty bad for me to go negative on anybody, really. And that shoot interview I did was like the most boring thing ever. So, and the guy, you know, I told the guy, I said, sorry, you know, but that's I told you going in, man, you know. So
yeah, I was thinking that it's Israel here, and I was thinking, you know, if I went into the wrestling business, right, I would definitely have to be a villain, because I just don't do the nice guy shit, right? So, tell me what you think about this whole scheme, right? Because maybe I'll stop doing radio. I was thinking about going as El Negro. And the thing that would be so scary is I'll be a social deviant. I'm like, I'm going to steal your car, or like kind of like Mr. Repo Man. You remember him? And then,
Repo Man.
Yeah, like, you know, I want to be like this social thug, an urban thug. You know what I mean? And I think it'll scare.
And we got too damn many urban thugs. Yo,
you see what I'm saying? And that's my plight.
Well,
no,
I definitely think you should quit radio. No, I'm just kidding.
I should stick to radio.
I think you should quit radio for sure.
No. See, I knew you'd see the genius in that plan.
Well, you will, just, right. If that's you do exactly that, what I meant. See a bunch of hands come up.
I'm just giving you a hard time, man. You know what? It's not so much the character; it's the person that plays it. And I really do believe that if you could take something that seems so ridiculous, guys have done it in the past in the business. You know, they took a thing that should have never worked and they made it work, and by the same token, guys have been given big opportunities and great characters to play and haven't been able to do anything with it. So, you know, it's a character can sound great on paper, but it comes down to the performer every single time.
And Dan?
Yeah, when I was a porn star for a week, they told me the exact same thing. It's like, the character's all right, but your performance lacks luster.
Ooh, that sounds like a short story.
Yeah, that was pretty much it. So the connection that I have with the porn and wrestling is that I DDT the producer.
You DDT the producer?
I did. Yeah, I did.
Did you short arm curls on them, picked them up like Jake? Boom.
No, I put them in the Iron Eagle. Remember the sheet? You know, you were speaking about characters that you hated that were just so great. I'm going to give you a couple that, like, just stick out of my mind. Big Boss Man. Okay. Uh-huh. He kicked ass, yep. And I hated him because he'd always win. The Mountie.
Oh, he was great.
Mountie?
The Mountie.
That's another case of a guy who, I mean, that, you know, that could have just been so cartoonish and so silly, but Ray Traylor was an incredible performer, so he made it work, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, then the Mountie. He got on my nerves, too, because he just would always win. Sergeant Slaughter. Yep. I hated that guy.
Yeah.
Like, I just, he just, I don't know, I just didn't like him. You know what I mean? And I don't know. So those three guys stick out in my mind as people I hate. But then, like, you had Bobby Heenan.
It sounds like you have a problem with authority. That's what it sounds like.
You know what? It might be some truth to that.
I think it is, man.
Yeah.
You don't like the Shield either, I bet you.
Nah. Nah, I don't. I'm for the urban thugs. You know what I mean? Like,
they don't do so well.
The Booker T's and...
Booker T's a thug.
He was for like 2 weeks.
G.I. Bro or something?
Yeah, I guess, I don't know, man. So, what was that?
I don't know. He has so many gimmicks.
I'm going to say the worst character ever was a guy named Coco Beware. You guys remember that guy? He had the parrot. He was real flamboyant. I mean, he was like...
He's in the Hall of Fame.
Exactly!
Oh, man, how bad he is, there is.
Yes, because he's the official spokesman for transgender wrestlers. Everyone knows that. It's in the Geneva Convention.
It's in the Geneva Convention.
It is. I read it.
All right, next question.
Well, hey, Shark Boy, before we let you go, we're letting everybody ask you a couple more questions. Chris, jump in there, man.
Who do you think is the next big star in wrestling? Do you have any young guys Shark you think? Boy. Oh, I know Shark Boy's already a star.
I think you got to keep your eye on Dean Ambrose. He's of course, a member of the Shield. He came from my area here. He's trained in Cincinnati and lived here for a while. And I know what he's capable of doing. He's very talented, and I think he's going to wind up emerging as a major star in the WWE. It's only a matter of time. You know, that group will probably stay together for a while, and then they'll kind of all, you know, they'll all do their own thing. And I think he's the one to keep an eye on.
That's cool. And what one thing do you not like about the business?
About what?
The wrestling business. One thing you don't like about the business.
Well, the toughest thing for me was always was the travel. I had a little boy, and it was always tough for me to leave. When he was one year old, I had to go to England for a month, and that was really tough.
Oh, man.
So I would say not so much the travel doesn't really bother me as much as time away from your family. I would say that's the biggest drawback.
There it is. Back to you, Jiggy.
Israel, you got anything for Shark Boy before we let him go?
Hey, man, I thank you for participating and putting up with my shenanigans.
Well, no problem.
Don't scare you away, Shark. Thank God.
Yeah.
Hey, make him do one of the impressions of Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Yeah. Could you get a promo on Israel in the Stone Cold Shark Boy voice?
Well, Israel, I'd like to sit here and say a bunch of negative things about you, but frankly, I don't know who the hell you are.
I love it.
It's awesome. Well, Shark Boy, this has been fun. We're going to let you get back to the NFL. And,
yes, sir.
We definitely... Sir, who walked in behind us? And then we'll... I definitely want to talk to you in the next couple months. Thanks for making this happen, and thanks for being on today, brother.
Absolutely. If I could just get a little cheap plug in.
Yes,
website,
go.
Sharkboy.net. You can email me straight from the website. I also just got on Twitter. I'm a little late in the game here, I know. But that's Sharkboy.net. So easy to remember, Sharkboy.net or Sharkboy.net on Twitter. Get a hold of me. Let me know what you want to see out of Sharkboy in the future, and let your local promoters know that you want to see Sharkboy on their shows.
One last question for you, Sharkboy. What song do you come out to?
I have a theme that TNA actually wrote for me. They wrote me a couple or three different themes, but I generally use the one starts with the glass breaking and sounds very similar to another certain wrestling superstar.
That's
the theme I use now. There you go. Yeah, that's the one I use now.
All right, that's what I. You need to switch to hip hop.
No,
he
don't.
Okay.
You can kick more ass.
Stay popular, don't do that.
You can kick 33% more ass to hip hop. Floyd Mayweather comes out to hip hop and he kicks ass.
Different sport.
That's true. That's true. That adds up. You're right.
Ass kicking is universal.
Ass kicking is universal. Yes.
Well, thanks for having me on, guys. I appreciate it, man.
Definitely. We'll talk to you soon, Sharkboy. Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
All right, man. See ya.
See ya. Shark Boy with us today here on the Jiggy Jaguar Experience. Good stuff. Shark Boy is fabulous.
He is.
And we are going to put that interview video and audio up on jiggyjaguar.net.
You need to hit those wrestling sites too.
And I'll send it out to the wrestling sites and see if they'll pick it up. I know that, we might be able to get tpww.net to pick it up. And maybe some of these others. But you're listening to Radio Xenu, also talkradiox.com. And you can watch us live at jiggyjaguar.net. We're going to take a quick timeout here. And when we come back, we are going to get a hold of a guest who has been texting me and saying he's waiting. So I don't exactly know who this is. So we'll find out who it is, and we'll get back. We might chat with Jennifer for a minute and find out why is it that all Hutch women guard their vaginas like they're gold. We're going to do that when we get back here on a world-famous Jiggy Jaguar Experience.
The Jiggy Jaguar Experience. Here is Jiggy Jaguar.
Let's make sure we talk about the strains.
Oh, yeah. We're gonna do
I hate the thought of you with him.
It's an all new love for me when I see you again. Smiling on the outside, crying on the inside. When will it end? Will it ever end? A diamond does not only shine if you take away the light and hide it in the dark. Shining on the outside, dying on the inside. When will it end? Will it ever end? It's like this slow motion knife thrust.
Hey, what's going on? It's Biggie. Couple of minutes, it's gonna be good to go here with you. Okay, before we get on the air with you, first of all, I need to know website. How do we? What is the website? Manchris.com. And just refer to you as Manchris.
I wish that I had known you then. We could have laughed away the things that make you think of him.
Nice,
shining on the outside.
That will
shining
work.
On the inside.
You got like a reverbation thing, right? To find some music.
I didn't know you then, but it's this slow motion knife thrust. And the pain hits all at once.
Oh, hey, I think I might have that.
You're better than that.
That's right. That sucks.
You should be free.
There we are. Okay, I got music for my yard. I will talk to you here about 1 second.
You should be with me.
Right,
you're
rapper.
I'm a rapper.
I love it. I love rappers. The big time.
You should shine. You should be with me.
Simon says,
Jiggy Jaguar Experience continues after a short break on the Jiggy Jaguar Radio Network.
Look at that, playing liners in reverse. It is the Jiggy Jaguar Experience. Coast to coast, to border, all over the World Wide Web, over there. Yes, indeed, at JiggyJaguar.net. And coast to coast on 50-plus radio stations across the U.S. and Canada. And cousin Chris in the building today.
Yes.
My God, we got Chris somehow in the building.
Well, I had to put my dad away, so.
Oh, my God. I put my dad away.
No, he's serious.
And we got that... the man, the myth, the legend, the official.
And we got too damn many urban thugs. Yo.
Israel in the building.
The Midwest mogul in the making.
And people, you can't see this, but I'm shaking my head again to them.
That's right. We're going to go to the phones.
What about her?
Oh, yeah. There she is on the couch.
Little Jennifer.
Little Jennifer, the hood rat.
She needs to get a nugget. No, it's deep.
Well, hey, she showed Israel her cans last night.
Of course she did.
Yeah, we were at the liquor store. What are you talking about?
Oh, can you give me some liquor? Bam! I got it.
I tried asking if they only had a 2-pack, but...
See, yeah, I was like...
You got a 12-pack in there. I
just want you guys to know that Jiggy's whore meter is very off. Jennifer's a wonderful girl.
Yes, she is.
She's not
a wonderful girl.
She's not the resident hood rat.
She took a needle in the toe and like a champ.
She took the needles?
Three times.
The needles?
Thrice.
She took it like a champ. She cuts a little bit, but it's okay.
Now, we had a phone guest, but he disappeared. Oh. There he is.
What's up?
It is Matt Chris in the building.
Matt Chris.
Getting it in. Forget about what you've heard. Forget about ferrets and jello fights. We got Matt Chris on the horn, baby. And look at that shit. He's in the building. He's pretty much what all the ladies talk about when they say Matt Chris is the king, and he's here, wow, and he's getting it in, and he's getting in where he fits in, and all that shenanigans. And if you want to get more information on this guy, you can check out MattChris.com. Also, he is on the Twitter. Tell us about your Twitter experiences, my friend.
Oh yeah, I'm on Twitter at MattChris973. MattChris973 and Instagram the same thing. So, you know, hit me up. You know, I holla back and all that good stuff.
He will, as they say, holla back.
Let me holla at you. Matt Chris, tell us about yourself. What type of music do you do?
Yeah, man. I do hip hop.
You do?
Yeah, hip hop. We recently released a record called Off the Charts. It released a couple weeks ago, so you know, we're just getting it out to the people.
How's the record doing?
It's doing really, really good. It's an exclusive Dat Piff, and we have a few thousand downloads in a couple weeks. So you know, it's doing really, really good. A lot of streams as well. So you know, we're just performing a lot of shows, doing a lot of radio interviews, and just spreading the word.
All right. Do you do your own production, or who does your production? Who produced it?
Yeah. We got a team of producers here. Some of the guys on the album is DJ Pro Maserati. He's a producer. This guy named Hunger and this guy named J Dot. You know, they do the majority of the production on the album.
Well, okay. Well, what were some of your musical influences?
Yeah, really, really, just like my childhood and life experiences. Kind of like everything I go through, I really, really wanted to catch the fans up with this record on what I've been doing and things I've been going through. So really just like real life experiences and you know, things that I see that happen to me as well as things that I see that happen to people around me.
And I'm going to ask you a very important question.
Yeah.
How many titties per second is on your album?
Titties per second?
How many times do you reference breast in your music?
Honestly, man, we don't really reference breast, but we do reference, like, you know, beautiful women and
titties make you nervous.
And, good times out partying in a nice seat, you know.
Houston, we have a problem.
I'm just saying, titties makes all music better.
Yeah, they do.
You know, like if you're singing a gospel song, you're like, Jesus, love titties. This I know. That song would be 45% better. Automatically.
Well,
yeah,
man,
you know.
Well, hey.
A wide range of fans for that.
Matt Chris is with us. If you're watching for our TV viewers over there on JiggyJaguar.net and YouTube, you can see a little bit of his. Well, we're watching the music video in the background. I believe it's for Get Down. Yeah, and tell me about this music video. You have got some fine looking. I guess we would call them
women.
Ebony perv magnets. I do like the one in the pink. She is quite entertaining, and she's doing all sorts of she's making it so I can't get up from my desk here in a few. But tell us about this video. Where was this filmed at? And give us the background on this. It's a pretty cool little video.
Yeah, sure. So Get Down is a video. It's was shot at Webster Hall in New York City, and what we did was. We rented you know, the VIP section out, and basically just called a lot of friends out and just shot. You know, we had a couple of bottles and a good crowd. So, you know, shout out to everybody that came out to that video shoot.
Now, Chris believes there's hood rats in this music video.
It's a very It's a very diverse, wide range of people.
He's keeping it clean. I love that.
We got you know, a diverse, wide range. You know, we got some really, really, really pretty girls that are, you know, doing things, and some that are not so much.
Here we go, Israel, jump in there.
I'm just going to say that he is compliant with the 1936 Act of Congress that says you have to have at least 5-to-1 ratio hot bitches to bad to whack bitches per video. Gotcha. Now, go look that up. Go look that up.
Oh, yeah.
Let's just look that up.
Sure.
Now, Chris's problem here at the radio station here is that he doesn't get any women. No hood rats, no good girls.
Oh, my God.
So he's looking at your video, and he's thinking to himself, how long is this video? And he's like, okay, 3-4 minutes long. I can get a lot of spank action going in 3-4 minutes. Now, the problem is that you're going to pop in Professor the video intravenously as a male, and he doesn't go that way. So
Israel's going to defend the rappers on the show.
Of course.
That's why he's on the part of the show.
It's because hip hop truly drives the industry. It's the hip hop culture in general that drives a lot of music, obviously, film, and fashion. So, yeah, I'm representing. He's doing his thing, man. It's a good quality video. There's bitches in the video. There's bitches in the video. And he's doing his thing. It's hip hop. So, what else does there need to be? In my perfect world, Barack Obama would come out to his new, like, you know, he'd do like the presidential address and shit. And first, you know, he'd like have Pharrell make the beat for him when he came out, and he would freestyle like the whole address, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
you know,
that's not gonna give him shit.
It will work. That, you know what I mean? Yeah. He'd be like, mama is Barack Obama, and I'm curing everything from diphtheria to terrorists in Syria. Ooh. That's a freestyle, by the way. And you would listen in. You'd get blown and you listen to Barack freestyle about shit. And then Michelle could do a twerk video afterwards, and it'd be perfect.
I know why Chris is disagreeing with you.
The professor has entered the building.
In Chris's perfect world, CM Punk is the president. And
can't do any more.
When other world leaders do not agree with Punk, he body slams them.
Sometimes people
like that guy over in Syria. I'm pretty sure Obama's going to do the right thing and drop a bomb on the guy. But Punk would just do one of them atomic brain busters on him. And then he would call in some of his reinforcement guys, and they'd, you know, just do them one of them lumberjack matches where they surround Syria, and they Punk parachutes in and beats the president up. CNN videotapes it. It's all over. And he raises national spirit. Now, I know that's Chris's secret plan.
That is, but the problem is with that is that, and Matt, Chris, you can agree with me at any time. in the hip-hop world, we really don't give a shit.
Oh, I know.
You better be giving a shit.
Now, if CM Punk could teach you how to sell crack, then we'd be there. Because that's important. That's important. Tell us, tell the viewers, never mind him. Tell the viewers.
Again, focus on crack.
Again, tell them where they can find you, because as independent artists, the first thing that people do is forget about you. You know what I mean? So tell the people where they could go find you again. What's your Twitter? What's your Facebook?
Yeah, my Twitter is Matt Chris, MATTCHRS973, and it's the same for Facebook and Instagram. As I said, you know, holla at me. You know, I always get back to people. And also, the website is mattchris.com, MATTCHRS.com, and, you know, those are accessible there as well. So check me out.
Well, hey.
Hey, I got one more quick question for him.
Okay, yeah, go.
I'm going to start asking all the rappers, because Israel and I had this long conversation last night, and I've had it with Chris Jasper from the Isleys, Jiggy and I did. We want you to think about what ingenious way there is to get your name out there as an indie artist. And, I mean, literally think that over, you know, constantly, and find a way that no one else is doing to get your name out there, get your music out there, be able to sell a few CDs. And besides something that people already aren't doing, just another avenue. Have you thought about this before?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, often, very often. one thing that I think is really, really big is to go out to the different radio stations, and you know, like we're doing now, you know, interview and basically.
Jesus Christ!
You know, go state.
We're being
state,
invaded.
State. So
look at that! We're being invaded by a. I don't mean to interrupt, Mr. Matt, but we're being invaded by my cousin. Her boyfriend, I guess we'll just call him. He spent enough money; he had to be the boyfriend.
True story.
Sammy, who I believe has just recolored her hair extra red for today's occasion.
It's like blood gang red.
One of the greatest hip hop managers in the history of the business, and some guy named Capella. But go ahead and finish what you were saying there. I didn't mean to cut you off. We were just being invaded there, my friend. Go.
Nah, all good, man. Shout out to everybody that's over there, you know, showing love and coming to the station. You know, it's always good. But I was saying, you know, more so just going radio station to radio station, different cities, and really, really spreading the music that way, as well as just like, you know, just being real and the actual product. You know, it's just reflecting you. I think that it's a lot more rewarding to the fans and just the listeners in general if you're yourself and you're being true to yourself and you're being real. You know, it really resonates well.
I've talked to, as an artist myself, this is Israel's talking, as an artist myself and meeting some other artists, one thing that I found about being an independent artist is that what some people see as a disadvantage is actually an advantage. When you're signed to a label, and this is from experience from talking to people who are signed to major labels, you're kind of limited in the things that you can do. As an independent artist, you can be as innovative as you need to be to get your point across. I grew up in a pretty rough neighborhood, and I got a lot of friends that are pimps. So what I did was I gave CDs to their hoes. So when the tricks came and bought the hoes, they just put the $5 price into what they were going to do anyway. And then it's a distribution channel, man, and it works. You know, you got like all these older guys. I'm telling you, you got to be innovative. Think about it.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man.
You got to come up with your own distribution channel.
Bro.
Right. I mean, because people are going to get prostitutes anyway. Not that we're advocating it.
Oh, my God.
I'm not, because we want them to be safe and clean and healthy. And to sell CDs, you know what I mean?
Oh my God.
It only takes a minute of our time, dude. Like, you know, they're going at it, and she's like, oh, yeah, by the way, before you finish, here, you got the CD. It was in the price. And he's happy about it. He has a souvenir. All right? Just think about it. How many pimp friends do you have? Just think about it, Matt Chris.
That's awesome. Yeah, but you're hysterical, man. That's funny.
I'm telling you, I went double nickel last year. double nickel off of prostitute CDs alone. My mom wouldn't talk to me for about 2 weeks, but I took her to Denny's and it was all good. But think about it.
Should have taken her to Popeyes. Oh, everything would have been 10 times.
It's all black people like chicken, huh? Well, we do, but I didn't want chicken. You got chicken at Denny's.
Jesus. Well, hey, but before we let you go, we do want to play a little bit of a track of yours, which is a good one for us to play. I got the mixtape pulled up here.
Which one has titties in it?
On Dat Piff. Yeah, which one has titties in it?
Most of them. Yeah, I mean, well, video, you know, we got to get down and try to make a love video out right now. We just recently released a So For Sure record with Jada Kiss. Maybe that's a good one to play. It's just kind of picking up on radio out here in different networks. So
we're gonna play that. So For Sure, kind of hold. Hey, hold on a little bit. We're gonna, because I want to get your thoughts on this. We're gonna play a little bit of it. Just hold on to the line, okay, brother.
We're gonna
get this going. It's going to.
Yeah. In on the long time. I got this. So natural. So natural. Oh. crushed to death way before your diaper. They hands on the side like they wish your wipers. Jet black diamond, no care if y'all like us. Truth business like we out at Rikers. So I act like shit, I call it Spider. Like no cord, but I'm still on wire. Light lighters up, hold up your lighter. If I ignite it up, hold up your... Make fire, take me higher, blue 90K prior. Aspire to inspire, do whatever you desire. But fight to get higher, that time goes wider. Rider with fire, feel like I'm Ghost Rider. Black pants, white bitch, backside wider. Flyer attire, make niggas retire. Four lanes, hide your blame, who the
driver? Oh my god, they played it commercial.
MC, that's me. I'm a bit off, thought on pit off. How you gon' win if you never took a lid off? Summer's in the feds, summer's up mid off. Either for sale or blowing the nearest wig off. Strength is in the numbers, one move, we all move. On the low, OT, moving that dog food. He's in the street, pissing drunk, they all new. We be high top swaying, they all blue. Trees in the thermal, yeah, the Uzi attorney. Playing the game like the roof, don't concern. Yeah, sparking from the bottles, you don't move, they're purple. Outsider, but I make moves internal. I don't do the slots, might hit the dice. Fall on me when the light hit the ice. If it ain't the ratchet, you gotta be the knife. Mama say it's foolish, I say it's the life. I walk through the door. Grinding and grinding on the floor. I'm all the more, cause my swagger all. I'm fucking sure, they get on the floor. I'm fucking sure, 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 gotta get it for long.
Back here on Radio Xenu, also talkradiox.com. I'm, of course, Jiggy Jag, Jigman Freud. Of course, the, we got to find, what is it? What is it? The wannabe podcaster. That's always a good one. And I don't even have enough time in a two-hour show to explain how odd that statement is and how wrong it is. But we've got Matt Chris on the line. We just heard a great track. We have also been joined by my cousin Tylen and her blue hair, Sammy and her red hair, and if we can find somebody with white hair, we'd have the whole American flag. Hey, Susan building as well, or as we're gonna start calling him, Mr. Moneybags in the building. And then we've got Jennifer the Hood Rat over there who broke her toe at the Kansas State Fair while riding rides. I don't know how that happened.
In the building.
And then we've got Capella in the building. Forget about what you've heard. Forget about tarantulas at picnics. Capella's in the building.
Yes, sir.
How y'all doing?
3-1-6 up. And Israel's in the building. And, of course, everybody's favorite. The man who, and I'm going to get buried for this later, but I just have to say this because I have to get a cheap pop off everybody. But the only man in the history of the business who walks into restaurants and they go, "Sir, may I take your coat?" Because of Chris in the building. And
he's back and he's hairy.
It's okay.
He's back and he's hairy.
It's okay. Come on, we can take your spot too. You're out of CDs.
Yeah, you're out of CDs and you'll disappear too.
I got a whole tour lined up. I have
another tour, people.
It's the Wichita tour. It's Twin Lakes Retirement Home on Monday. It's Manicare on Tuesday. Where?
Good Sam.
Nah, they don't get crunk enough for me.
No, I don't like them.
Jesus.
Those guys are on a lot of downer meds. I like my senior citizens to be on uppers. So, yeah. So I'm like, me and my senior, they be turned up. Like, yeah, Miss Betty, turn up. Turn up in that wheelchair.
Turn up.
Have you ever seen a wheelchair twerk video? Nah, you don't want to see that.
Well, Matt, Chris, before we let you go, give us your let's have everybody jump in. We just heard that great track.
Yeah, I'm feeling it, man. Hit me up on Twitter, and I'll repost it for you. I'll do anything I can to support other artists, man. As independent artists, it's our time. And, man, we just got to get to that next level. And in closing, fuck Cousin Chris, because he's a hip-hop hater. I told him the other day he's like the white Charlemagne. I told him, but he didn't want
to
listen.
Yeah, shout out to Charlemagne, man. He's a guy out here, man.
Go yeah, I love him. He's honest. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I want him to do my eulogy because he'd be honest about this shit. Like, you fucking sucked. You know, his album was all right. I'm kind of glad he
good
did
job.
It. Yeah, I really don't even know.
Just made a CD of him.
Yeah, basically.
Cut his ass up.
Follow me at _Israel, IZREAL. I got 6.7 billion fans, and I'll retweet to all of them.
Yes.
Potentially.
Well, hey, Matt, Chris,
IZARL?
Is real. Yep.
Is real.
And
I earned it. I didn't make it up myself.
Steve, go ahead and mention your Twitter.
Capella Music. Anything you want, like Facebook, Twitter, just Capella Music, Kapela Music.
Look at that. Well, Matt, Chris, thank you, sir. Thanks for being on today, man. Appreciate it.
Yeah, fun having you, man. I appreciate y'all for having me, man.
Don't have time.
Come back soon. With music about titties.
That'd be good.
With music about titties.
You mention titties, it'll make 10 times better.
And strippers with CDs.
See,
there you go.
That's right.
You can rest them in the butt. While they slide down the pole.
So Israel, explain to me once again this marketing plan with prostitutes and CDs.
Well, it's pretty simple. Because prostitution is like the oldest profession known to man, right?
Yeah, that's true.
And it's two things that go good together. You know, you got peanut butter and jelly. You got beer and pretzels.
BJ's
and you got
CDs.
Yeah, BJ's and CDs.
Oh my God.
And they just happen to go well together. You know what I mean? So this is what we call twat distribution.
Oh my God.
And you find a local pimp, right? Not a simp, not a pretend pimp, but a real pimp.
A real
who
pimp.
Got,
pimp.
Who got
pimp.
Hoes, right?
Yeah.
And what you do is you give the pimp the CDs and tell him charge an extra $5 per service, you know, per VJ.
Jesus.
And then that's how you make your money back. So every time she turns a trick, you sell a CD. It's amazing. It's amazing.
I paid
my cell phone bill last month off of that alone.
Matter of fact, you can have them play the music while they doing what they doing.
There it is.
I got songs about titties. It's great for VJs,
you know?
With CDs. You know?
Yes,
so,
yes, yes.
You know, you say money. Thank you for helping me.
So it's
because I only advocate clean prostitutes.
So essentially,
check, do it, been verified on them.
She's dirty. She can't.
Between what Israel and what Capella just contributed there, I think we're going to have a new hip-hop revolution here.
I'm trying to tell you, and it's starting in Wichita. We get it in.
It's already in Wichita. We get it in.
Broadway. I'm selling CDs on Broadway. You know what I mean? That's a new one.
Well, welcome to the world-famous Jiggy Jaguar Experience. Of course, 53 minutes after the hour, in the next hour, we will talk to my good friend, Mr. Ryan, out there at the Cotillion, about what is going on at the Cotillion.
Yeah, so he does a great job, man, of supporting independent artists. The Cotillion has been a backbone of the music scene in Wichita for years, since I was a little kid, and we really appreciate him. It's you know, it's wonderful to have him on the show this week.
Now,
Ryan.
I think it's awesome that we had Shark Boy on earlier from formerly awesome. Of TNA Wrestling, and Chris was in the building for that.
Drooling.
I would have rather him done a Scott Hall impression. Hey, yo.
Steve, can you come out here?
Oh, my God.
Hey, yo.
Hey, yo. I'm drunk.
Now, Let's talk to Capella over there. Capella Music in the building.
What's happening, bro?
Yep.
That was his name. It's just Capella Music. It's not his name. Rap name?
No, you know,
he's a hip hop painter, baby.
Because
oh,
no. You're white, it's okay. All right,
let me address this, Chris.
It's his rap name.
Right?
Well, first of all,
you don't even know who he is.
First of all, I'm gonna tell you why I know who he is. First of all, when you're asking a guy his name and he's in the building, you can't look at me and ask me about him. Ask him.
I don't know, sorry.
Second of all, I pay attention to the music in my city. I see who's doing what. And I see whose name repeatedly pops up and who doesn't. And I pay attention to those who market. In the last week or two alone, I've seen 3 or 4 songs on Facebook of yours. I've seen 2 or 3 posters around town. And at least 2 or 3 other artists have spoken to me about him. Now, you hip-hop hater. Let's proceed. First, 316 up.
Yep.
Tell everybody where they can find you at.
Man, check me out on Twitter, Capella Music. The reason why I got the music after that was I try to find every domain name I could find without the music in there, and it was already taken. But trying to line it all up, I got it in Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Everything's the same thing. Capella Music. So as soon as you Google that, you'll find me.
I think you've been you and your manager, you guys been doing a good job of promoting, man. As a independent artist, man, like for me, who's an artist myself, I can kind of gauge a little bit how well somebody's marketing is doing by how many times I'm seeing them, how many different places I'm seeing them at, and how many people are talking about them. So that lets me know you're effective, you know. And I talked to these guys last week, and you know, my first show was at my mom's Tupperware party, you know. Rocked it, you know what I mean? I rocked it. I was like, you know, my grandma, she lit her lighter for me and everything. And that was good till the smoke alarm come off. So, you know, when I see another person from my town who's focused and they getting it, man, you got your own hat, merchandise, man, that's just not free. You know what I mean? You can't put all that on the backs of prostitutes, shirts. He has a manager. You know, in order for you to have a manager, you have to be doing something to manage, right? You know what I mean? Like, and that's just what it is. So tell us about your new project you got coming out.
First of all, let me talk about the last project that we worked on, Kick City.
Kick City.
The mixtape. That's out right now. You can get it on iTunes. You can get it on Amazon. You can get it hard copy. I got those too.
Yeah.
So whatever it is, like, you need, however you need to get it, I got it for you.
You did? You
know, yeah, and it's a good project. It took a lot of hard work. It took a lot of time, a lot of money.
Yeah,
but,
yeah.
But, you know, it's an incredible project, which is kind of like an intro to Capella, who Capella is.
Right.
But the next project that we're working on, actually coming out next year, 2014, it's called The Hangover, Tales of a Prodigal African.
That's what's up.
Yeah, that's my
shout out. Shout out to my boy Fabrice, you know what I'm saying? My man Fire, we went to Wichita State together. Shout out to Nana, you know what I'm saying? The whole African community supports me. Stan Boy. Yeah, you know, them is my guys. And you alluded to something. Me and Jiggy, we came up with a little section, and we call it Step Your Game Up. And what it's about is designed for independent artists to learn from other independent artists and from already signed acts on how to actually step your game up. If you've been following me on Twitter or Facebook, you've been seeing my campaign, No More Whack Locals. And what that is about is...
Mike Game. That's what it's about. Mike Game. No.
My whack. No More Whack Locals. You got to join the movement. You know what I mean? It's about bringing a certain standard to the Wichita music scene. You know what I mean? You got to have a certain standard. Like, do you want to buy burgers from a greasy, dirty looking place, or do you want to buy burgers from somewhere look clean? Obviously clean. You got to step your game up. And there's certain things that you just have to do that separates you from being a person who rap versus being an actual artist. And I like to deal with artists, you know what I mean? People who have a project out. He said he got hard copies. You understand what that means? That means that he invested his time and his energy and his money into his project. Don't be running up on me with burnt CDs, with Sharpie on it, you know what I'm saying? Talking about, yo, can I get $10? Nah, get at me when you're professional. That's all I'm saying. You feel me, Capella?
True that, man. You got to put money in it. There's no way around it.
I mean,
everybody starts over there. You know, everybody starts with the Sharpie. You know, I started there. You know, like the first, it's the first thing you do when you record straight into your computer and you think you got a hit, and you know, then everybody's like just gonna fuck with you because.
Yeah, you hope you know, so.
You got a Sharpie and a CD, man, and that's what you do, but. You got to get to a point where you're like, okay, who am I competing with? Am I competing with somebody with a Sharpie, or am I competing with Wayne up there that's actually making all that money? Where you trying to go? What you trying to do? What you trying to do with this music? Are you rapping to be a local star, or are you rapping to be a global star?
Yeah.
Quality counts.
Absolutely, man.
And that's management saying that.
You can't record something that sounds like it came out of your basement.
You did. Like, you recorded on the toilet stool yesterday morning. Now...
He had reverb in it.
I'm not trying to discourage nobody. I'm not. I'm saying that the gift and the curse, me and Jig talked about this last night. The gift and the curse about hip hop right now is that it's so easy to do it. You know what I mean? Like when I first started rapping, man, in Wichita, it was in those studios. It was only 4 or 5 producers. You know, for you then to get an album out took so much more effort than it does now. Now you can just go download Pro Tools and go download Fruity Loops and you think that, you know what I mean, you're going to be the next Dr. Dre. Fuck that. Learn to write rhymes. Y'all need to stop listening to Lil Wayne and all these other cats who tell you, I don't write, it shows. You know what I mean? Develop your skills, you know what I mean? Like,
you gotta listen to our girl Sammy.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Thug Nasty, shout out. You know what I'm saying? Like,
Thug Nasty?
I want somebody. I'm only one person. You know what I mean? And I met some artists who were cool people who I didn't dig their music, but more people did. So that's all that matters. It's not about that. It's about the effort that you put out to get it done. You know what I mean? And I respect that. When I see somebody's CD and it's nicely packaged and it's barcoded and it's shrink wrap, I know how much you went into it. You know what I mean? Those strippers know how much went into it because they carried the CDs and they sold them.
They sell those hard copies.
And, but because I'm stripper friendly, prostitute friendly, when I push my CDs on them, I'm eco-friendly because I get, you know, packaging that has a little, small footprint. And I get paper so that it's lighter so that they don't have to carry around heavy plastic all day because I care. It may not seem like a lot, but, you know, 10, 15 CDs on one prostitute is like an extra pound of weight that you're carrying all night on those heels. But they're professional.
On those heels.
I'm serious, dude.
Now that's a good manager right there. They should hire you at Walmart, man. Like, just manage it.
You know what I mean? I think I get it done.
Care
I mean,
about the employees, man.
Walmart would be popping. You would come and shoot dice to pay your bill. Like, hey, 7-Eleven for the pork chop. 7-Eleven.
Oh my God!
Wow. Capella, talk to me about the hip hop scene in Wichita. How you view it and how you view yourself in it.
I'd say as far as hip hop in Wichita, like, people really up in their game, man. I mean, shout outs to people like Cash Hollister, SE Trill.
Yeah.
Like, it's a lot of people that you can it's a lot of people that you can name that's really like on it, you know, when it comes Big Sam, like
Dub Cuddy, that's, you know, my boy.
Man, I'm telling you, like, people is really coming up with their rhymes, man. They doing their thing. And I'm watching around, the competition is getting real.
Right.
But what we missing is unity, and that's the one thing, is because we're missing that, it's hard to like really create a scene. So everybody's just trying to do their own thing, you know what I mean? And it's not getting us nowhere.
I totally agree with you, man. I had to tell this other artist, you know, we was listening to another artist's music, he's like, oh man, I don't like this song, I don't like that song. And I'm like, look, man, if this song does well, and I hope it does, then that's good for everybody. If you're handling your business, if this person gets attention, then it's only going to bring attention on you. You know what I mean? So that's why, you know, here at KJAG Radio, we started the Step Your Game Up process. That's what the whole No More Whack Locals movement is about. It's really, underneath it all, is about having a certain level, like Shauna said, a certain level of quality. Mm-hmm. Some people have a lot of quantity, but they don't have a lot of quality. Mm-hmm. You fill up my Facebook page, you fill up my Twitter with all your SoundCloud and all your bullshit, and it sucks.
I'm just, you know, I'm just being honest with you. True. And then they're like, oh, well, it's a lot, why you don't want to play me? I'm like, well, because you're going to fuck up my credibility. And I'm not going to do that for you. You know what I mean? I work hard to get all 26 of my fans, and I'm keeping them. All 26 of them.
Jesus.
Man, that's the reality, though. That's the reality on the street, man. I mean, because it's so easy now. It's so easy to make a record. I mean, you can just put it on SoundCloud. It's free. Reverb Nation is free. You know, as soon as you put it up there and then you post it on everybody's wall, ain't nobody really trying to go with that. Now, people want visuals. You need to have videos. You need to have, you know, because with people. And that's if they click on it. That's just if they click on it. You know, so you got to promote it right, too. I mean, the work starts after you finish the record, really.
Hey, man, I'm feeling this guy, man. Me and Jiggy just said that last night. Like, you know what I mean? Like, that's just the start of the process once you actually make the record. It's like...
Oh, that's the basic.
Who can go buy a record that they don't know exists? You know what I mean? Like, you can't buy an album you don't know exists. And these guys will contest to hear. I'm out throughout the city of Wichita every weekend. This weekend I was at the fair. I was the only artist that I seen out there, any genre, passing out flyers, taking emails, selling CDs. I won't tell you how much I made because it's not enough to talk about, but I covered gas. But the point is...
And gas is expensive.
Right. The point is, you got people that's all over the state of Kansas at one time in one place, and now hundreds of people who didn't hear about me before have heard about me and will go back to their area and social network and build it up. So when I got 27 fans, you know why. Because
well, we're gonna do this. I don't mean to jump in there, but we gotta get Ryan on the line. So we're gonna take a quick little time out. We'll be back with Ryan from the Cotillion here on the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Experience.
You're so famous. You're so hot.
Israel, you need to go.
You're so gorgeous. Forgive me not. You're so luscious. A work of art. You're delicious. You got every heart. We'll be right back.
Ryan's the guy that runs the cotillion, right?
Yep.
We gotta push that ROH, man.
Well,
motherfuckers, crank it. You've got Jiggy Jaguar podcasting from www.jiggyjaguar.com.
We are back here on the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Experience, coast to coast and border to border, all over the world wide web over there at RadioZenu.com. Also, TalkRadioWax.com and 50 plus stations across the U.S. and Canada. Getting it in where we fit in. I guess that's what all the rappers say. And we are live every single Sunday from 2 to 4 Central, 3 to 5 Eastern, 12 to 2 Pacific. Live and direct at JiggyJaguar.net. We are about a half hour away from Labette Larry. But we've got Mr. Ryan from the Cotillion on the line. And Ryan, what's going on, brother? How are you?
Oh, nothing much, man. Just enjoying the Chiefs actually winning here. Good way to start the season, I guess.
The Chiefs are winning the game?
Oh, what?
You guys are
they won.
Playing Jacksonville. Come on, man.
Yeah, it was Jacksonville. It wasn't anything exciting, but, good way to start the season.
Now, we got Ryan with us today from the Cotillion. We got Cousin Chris in the building also. Mr. Israel.
The Midwest mogul in the making.
And Capella from Capella Music is also here, and we've got a few other little surprises as well. But Ryan, let's talk about Friday? Mm-hmm. Heck, it was this last Friday. Tech Nine was in the building. Tell us about how that concert went for you. I'm assuming that it was wall-to-wall packed people, right?
Great concert.
Yeah, it was a good show. He always brings in a good crowd and, packs the house. If you've never seen him live, it's quite the experience.
Now, Ryan with us today from the Cotillion. Catch him on Twitter, at the Cotillion. And the Round Mound of Sound is going to be hosting some big-time concerts. Talk about some of the big shows coming up to the Cotillion. I understand tickets are on sale for a lot of these shows and are selling very, very well. Talk to us about some of the big ones coming up.
Next one we got is Roller Derby next Saturday. And then we have Brett Eldridge, which is a free show, up-and-coming country guy, on September 18th. Got Lewis Black. Comedian doing the Rant Is Due tour September 26th. Then Marshall Tucker Band the next night, September 27th, with Live Wire. Trivium, wow. Devil Driver, October 11th. Art Aid, October 12th. Hairball, October 19th. Charlie Robinson and Roger Traeger, October 23rd. Donna the Dub, October 25th. Aaron Carter, November 1st. Stranger Smith, November 2nd. Breakfast Kelly, November 9th. Brian Regan, November 10th. Clutch and the Sword, which that's one I'm really excited about, November 15th. Jackal, November 22nd.
Jesus.
Bowling and the Stragglers, November 27th. I know it keeps going here.
My Lord.
November 30th. And then the Dutton, February 4th.
Do you get overtime?
Overtime?
You are there all the time.
We got a TV in the Cotillion right now. I'm watching the Chiefs win. No, I don't. I have a little cot I pull up out back.
Ah, okay.
He never leaves.
I didn't think so, because every time I come in, Ryan, you're there. It's like,
I'm there.
It's 6 in the morning, you're hanging up posters like... You right.
I need posters. I'm running around looking like I'm doing something at least. That's the name of the game.
I think, Ryan, that you just need to get a chain, a gold chain, two gold teeth, and start opening up every time Tech comes. Before you know
it. Yeah, gold chain. And they can call me one gold chain, two gold teeth. That'd be my rapper name.
See? Instead of two chains, you put one chain, two gold teeth.
One chain, two gold teeth.
And then you get all gold everything remix.
Oh, there it is.
You got nothing on 2 Chainz.
Yeah. Ryan, I want to say for the independent artists in Wichita, man, the Cotillion has been a great source of marketing for us and a way to get our music out to a larger audience. And what you guys do is great, man, and we really appreciate you. And we appreciate you here at KJAG. You guys were great hosting us the other day when we interviewed Tech N9ne and Chris Calico and the whole Strange guys. And I just want to say thank you for that.
It's a good time.
Thank you, man.
I had a question.
It's not just us. Everybody comes out, supports stuff like you guys and fans and everybody else that comes out and, you know, buys tickets is the name of the game. Keep the bands happy and they keep coming back.
Yeah, Tech N9ne, man, he's so popular, man. I was just on the bus talking to him, like standing by the side of the bus, and I got 3 phone numbers just because. Like, oh, you were standing next to Tech N9ne. I was like, if I'd have shook his hand, what else would you have done?
That easy, right?
I had a question as far as managers. How do they get a hold of
it? It's a grind, just like anything else. You know, put our hours in. And,
well, hey Ryan, we've got a question from our audience here in the building. Shauna, you had a question. Jump in there.
I was wanting to know how management would get a hold of someone at the Cotillion if they were interested in getting their art on a show.
I can't hear you. What was that?
Hey, if a manager wanted to get their artist in the Cotillion for a show to open up, like a local to open up, how do they get a hold of you guys over there? Who are you the guy to talk to? Is it Richard? Who's the one that we need to talk to get the information?
It's a little bit of both. Best thing is to send like an EPK to info@thecotillion.com. Then we have something on file and go from there. But you know, every show we don't need local support.
Yeah.
I like how you put that, Ryan. Local support.
Do what?
We're here to reinforce you. If you ever need me to sing up for Mary Had a Little Lamb, I'm there.
Well, just one thing comes through, right?
Right. I do Tupperware parties. I do bar mitzvahs. I do christenings. All of those.
You're diverse. You got 1 foot in right there.
Now,
It takes a lot, you know, the artists have to, management, label, and all that stuff. They all have to agree on who opens and all that good stuff. So it's not as easy as just us waving the magic wand and saying yes. So
yeah.
But, it's a little bit of this, a little bit of that, but there's a few steps there.
We've got Ryan from the Cotillion with us today. Thecotillion.com is the website. Check out the Round Mound of Sound on Facebook and Twitter as well. Let's talk about the show coming up next Saturday, ICT Roller Girls. You guys, my buddy Ross the Boss, the Rebel Rousing Ringleader, Mr. Ross Long, has been to a few of these and taped a few of these.
Yeah, he's moved on to Colorado now.
Yes, he is. He is now up in Colorado doing all sorts of things with herbs.
Amen, brother. Amen.
Now, Ross has told me on several occasions that the roller derbies, you have people lined out the door.
They get there early.
It is a phenomenon. Why is roller derby so popular in Wichita, and why is it that people just line up in droves and sell these events out at the Cotillion?
I have a theory to Ryan, and my theory about my theory is that, one, people like to go fast, right? Skates are fast, right? Skates are fast.
Yeah.
Two, the roller derby with the females have titties, so you have titties and fast. In fast one titties. Place. That's fast titties. That's why everybody shows up. That's
also,
my theory.
You also got bitches fighting, titties, so.
I guess that's one thing. But that's one thing, yeah. That way,
sex
but they, they've been around, I think, since 2006. So,
yeah.
You know, they've got their own little network going that they've, established over the years. And, you know, they've got something going for them. And last year, we became the home of all their home events, home bouts. So they kind of stepped up there at Skate South, and they kind of outgrew that place. So moved on up, and all the stuff that we can offer helps to bring in some new, diverse people. Last month when they had their home bout, it was packed. It was crazy packed. It was the busiest one they had all year. So,
well, it's good stuff,
yeah,
Ryan.
Yeah, it's fun. I always describe it as like a rock and roll family, you know, sporting event. That's kind of the best way to describe it. It's fun. They're good times.
Well, it's always a good time out there at the Cotillion. Cotillion.com is the website. That's www.thecotillion.com. Also follow them on Twitter at the Cotillion, also on Facebook, and they have all sorts of different information, concert events. You can get their mailing list. Also, for concert and event updates, you can text LIST to 49798 to receive special offers, discounts, freebies from the Cotillion, or you can go to the website and sign up there as well. And Ryan, looking forward to talking to you next week. Are you going to be doing any concert announcements this week, or is it are you fine for a while?
There's a couple of things. There's always something in the works. It's just a matter of when they all fall into place. And,
yeah.
The bands want them to get announced. But right now, I don't know if we have anything here we're announcing next week.
Well, Ryan, but, I heard that Wilson Phillips was thinking about getting back together. Keep an eye on that for me.
Wilson Phillips, and you're going to be open. St. Mary had a little lamb.
Right? See? That's why we're friends, see? Ryan. That's why.
And that APK would be good to go.
See? And for you artists who don't understand what an EPK is, that's an electronic press kit.
Press kit. There
so
you go.
That means you have to have stuff to actually press about. You know what I mean?
See, and if you don't know what EPK is, you probably shouldn't be trying to open for any band.
I try to tell you. I try to tell everybody, Ryan, now that you're here, because I'm going to eventually move up to the Cotillion. But I started my mom's Tupperware party. That's my first show.
Start somewhere, right?
And that's what my
gradually
EPK.
Work your way up. Get comfortable with, you know, 5 people, then 50, then 100. You know, keep going. So.
Man, I'm at 26 fans right now, man.
26
that's and going strong.
Right? That's the building point. We all started there, right?
Right. Now, if you let me rent out the bathroom at the Cotillion, I could sell that out, no problem. Tomorrow.
Yeah.
Tomorrow.
Yeah, I have no doubt in that. We'll put up flyers. We'll charge an extra admission just to get into the bathroom.
I think you should. Because, you know, people definitely rip off toilet paper and that cost.
A second ticket, that's right.
Second ticket. There'll be an add-on ticket. We could do that. Let's figure something out.
Yeah, I'll be like the meet and greets install number one.
And, you know.
Yeah, you're kind of like, you know, like on the fence there. I don't know. As long as the police don't hear about it, they might be thinking something else going on. But
yeah, well, and you know what we could do, and I'll probably catch heat for this from somebody, but they'll have to assign security. So we'll make Lance, the Midwest Mangler, be your security guy over there.
Yeah, that'd be interesting.
Well, Ryan, thanks, brother, and we'll talk to you next week. And Roller Derby is this Saturday. Doors open at 6, show at 6:30. The event is all ages. You can buy your tickets at thecotillion.com. And 1150, 1350, and sign up for the mailing list and everything over there at thecotillion.com. Thanks, Ryan.
All right, thank you, guys.
Definitely, peace. Man. Talk to you soon, man. Later. Ryan from the Cotillion here on the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Experience, and we're going to do this. We are going to play, yes indeed, we are going to play some music from our weekend co-host here, Mr. Capella today. Of course, Capella, we invited him to co-host with us today, and also get it in where we fit in, and of course when you're Israel, that's almost nowhere.
Yeah, pretty much.
And
I got what's called biggest blackest caucus. It's a disease that runs in my family. There's no cure.
There's no cure. None at all. Now, before we get into this track, Capella, tell us about this this track, Yellow Bricks,
and where they could find it at.
All right, Yellow Bricks. First of all, is paying homage to the Fugees. The first, like, very few people know this, but Lauryn Hill is one of my greatest influences. She was the first to, well, in my eyes anyway, when I was a kid, she was the first to sing and rap.
Right.
And that's something that I do. So I took the Radionaut beat and did a remix to it. And I'm just paying homage to that, but I'm also talking about life. And it's always like, it's always about life with me. It's always about what the real is out there.
Lauryn Hill was one of my first crushes. Yeah, she's the only reason I ever watched Sister Act.
only reason.
I really couldn't get into her like that. I really couldn't get into her like that, but musically, she was hot.
Yeah. The Fugees, the score.
She was hard, man. Though. She spit hard, man. Like, she could rap. Oh,
yeah, I know.
And then come like, back and sound like that.
Pin me down,
she
kiss
sang,
me, and freestyle to me all at once.
Man.
Wow. Like, if I dated Lauryn Hill, whenever we got into an argument, we like freestyle about it. You know what I mean? Like, we battle rap about
it. Did
she win
all the arguments then? You should let her win.
I let her win, but we definitely battle about it.
We battle
whatever,
about it.
You know what I mean? What's your issue? Who left the tissue? Put the seat down on the toilet.
Uh oh, we're getting a call. Let's see who this is. You're live on the world famous Jiggy Jaguar Experience. Who is this?
This is Amy.
Oh, hey, we were going to call you here in a few moments.
Hey, Amy.
We'll just talk to you now. How are you, Amy? You're live with Capella Music, my man Israel, the world famous cousin Chris, who's going to get thrown under the bus. I mean, we're going to have a discussion here in a few. And, of course, my cousin Tylan's in the building. She brought her friend Sammy, who colored her hair extra red today.
Thug Nasty.
Thug Nasty.
Jesus in the building with his big gold earrings, or silver earrings. I don't know. I just seen these huge earrings coming through the door. And then we've got our local hood rat, Jennifer. And Capella has brought management, and I also believe that he's also brought security. And what's great is that it's a two-for-one, because she's security and management.
Yeah.
And
she got her pistol on her, too.
That's right.
It fell out when she was coming up the stairs.
Well, Amy, let's talk. Give us a little bit on your background there.
Oh, okay. I am a cinematographer. I'm here based in Burbank, California. I recently worked on a short film with Josh Mitchell. He's like a big film publicist out here. The Corruption of Kitia Kitt. Looks like I'm submitting it to Sundance and a bunch of film festivals. I've been doing cinematography for about 10 years now, and I'm actually going to be on another feature in a couple weeks that's going to be released on AMC Theaters on 420.
Of course.
It's called 420, reluctantly.
Reluctantly? Oh. Hold on, time out.
Yeah, it's one of those movies.
Why reluctantly?
Reluctantly? Well, it's not really my cup of tea, but, you know, it's what pays the bills.
Was that a pun, your cup of tea?
Yeah, it really was a pun.
You know today is Sunday, right?
Yes, it is.
At least here in America. I don't know about another country, but here in America it's Sunday. And
I don't know about another country.
We believe in God in our country, and it says somewhere in the Bible, blah, 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 weed. And because it's in the Bible, I think... Not nearly enough yet. I'm getting agitated because I got cataracts or one of those mysterious things that you need for pot.
Yeah.
So
one of those mysterious things you need for pot.
I'm just saying that, and I'll let you finish because I don't want to interrupt you, but I don't want our core listeners to ever think that, you know, we're disrespecting marijuana, because we would never do that. And I just want to keep our core fans. So,
Bud Doobie in the house.
Bud Doobie. We got Bud Doobie sighting.
Now, since you're a cinematographer, for the folks at home and as Chris likes to say, the people of McPherson, Kansas, explain to us what a cinematographer is.
Okay, essentially my job is I take a script and I analyze the script and kind of come up with a look with the director for the film. And depending on the budget, I'm usually setting up the lights, coming up with the look. So when you go to a movie and you see, like, for example, watch a horror movie and it looks really dark and creepy, I'm responsible for setting that look. I'm responsible for... converting all of the director's vision to light and shadow, and setting up the shot, the composition, managing the entire camera, grip, and electric department. So I'm literally second in command under the director.
Okay.
Director handles everything visually, and I just translate it.
So are you the one in the movies that makes that horrible-looking fake weed in the movies? So you set that shit up?
I just want my reefer to look more realistic when I'm, because when I'm high and I'm watching the movie about getting high, I want it to be realistic. That's all I'm saying.
I'm actually translating whatever the director wants. If they want the person that's smoking marijuana to look like they're having antlers coming out and then smoke coming around, then I have to make it look that way.
Do you have to call it marijuana?
Yeah, it's whatever he wants. Whatever crazy idea he wants, I gotta make it happen. But also have other departments that do that stuff too.
When you call it marijuana, you make it seem like a drug. Yes. And everyone knows that it's not. It's more like a non-drug.
It is an herb.
What all films have you worked on?
Actually, I've worked on a couple feature films. Most of them have been like straight to DVD. A lot of music videos. I'm working on a couple documentaries right now, which I'm not only just doing cinematography. I'm actually directing and producing them. Okay. One's called John. It's like it's actually a really great story. It's about one of my girlfriends. She's a human trafficking survivor, and it talks about her survival and her link to organized crime, which is pretty interesting. That's pretty much what I do.
I really enjoy documentaries more than I really do movies. I like to learn something while I watch movies. You know what I mean? Like. I don't want to see a whole bunch of mindless stuff. And documentaries really keep your interest while you're high. And
yeah, you know. Oh
my God. I'm just saying. Especially documentaries about getting high. You know, I'm going to use my technical drug talk. It sets off my endorphins and my dopamines. And I get this euphoric feeling.
Endorphins and dopamines.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much it. What type of documentaries
I'm sure
do you like to watch?
I'm working on.
Huh?
I'm sure you'd like 420 when it comes out. It's pretty funny. It's actually going to be directed by one of the co-writers of the original Scary Movie and White Chicks.
Well, what I need you to do is follow me on Twitter so that I can tell everybody else to go follow it. And because I know, I know a lot of people who may or may not, depending on whether it's legal or not in their area, use, as you called it, marijuana. Or as the police call it, a marijuana cigarette. Which I really hate, because I don't do cigarettes. And I would have to quit if it was a marijuana cigarette. You know what I mean? Because I just don't do...
Yeah.
I don't do cigarettes. But I do documentaries. And I actually did one about myself.
Especially what you did call now.
And... I did a documentary about myself, and I'm the only person that watched it, but I loved it. I was more informed on myself at the end of the video. So putting together videos about myself helped me to understand what actually goes into producing a film. It's a lot of hard work, you know what I mean? Because you got to shoot hours worth of film, you know what I mean? Just for 30 minutes worth of footage, and I don't think... And I'm being serious now for this moment. And I hope people understand that. I'm clowning, but I respect your art. We wouldn't have you on the show if you weren't, you know, doing something and making moves and being progressive in the industry. So I really dig that, you know? So go follow me, and I'll retweet to all 6 billion of my fans, because I have 6 billion fans on Twitter and MySpace. I'm still on MySpace. Don't tell anyone.
Really?
Yes, dude.
You're so on MySpace. That's so ancient.
You didn't see the new commercials?
There's
new
she's commercials. Clowning you.
Mac Miller's on there. MySpace is back.
MySpace is back, baby.
It's like butterfly collar shirts. No, we back.
It's like I still have like a MySpace account, but I don't even know what happened to the password.
Yeah, I know. MySpace.
But yeah, I'll
check it out. Yeah, MySpace. Like it just turns into like, I don't know, a dark satanic social media site for pervs, like overnight.
Yeah, you know, that's why I kind of got off my face, because you had like a lot of spam and a bunch of weird perverts.
Yeah, I know, it's a scary. Like, last time I checked into my space, I felt like someone was watching me, you know what I mean?
That's just the NSA, don't worry about it. It's the NSA.
Yeah, I just felt like someone was watching me and they wanted to duct tape butt rape me. I was like,
with cupcakes?
No cupcakes.
No cupcakes. We'll have to explain to Capella and his management about the duck rape and the cupcakes.
Okay.
You may or may not get a cupcake.
Everybody got their thing, so. Cupcakes.
I'm just saying this stuff happens. It's America, guys.
Well, before we let you go, my friend, how do we find you on the internet? How can people check you out?
Yeah, people can check me out on my website, amiefilms.com. Now that's spelled Amy, A-I-M-E-E, films.com. And then you can have access to my Facebook, Twitter, and everything. But if you want to follow me on Twitter, it's Amy, A-I-M-E-E, G, Torres, with an S. So check me out. You can keep up to date with all the films that I'm working on. And I'm always posting some crazy photos behind the scenes because there's always somebody nuts on set that I'm always like, oh my God, why am I working with this person? It's fun.
Amy, you've been a great guest. You've made it through the Israel experience. And now you'll probably need to go get higher self. But if you say no, it's quite all right because theoretically, that means more for me. And that's all I'm going to say.
Yeah. I think I'm just going to have a nice, quiet evening here. Because in California,
You're in California, you said?
Yeah, I'm in California right now. The weather's, like, intense. It's, like, over, like, 100 degrees
so
out here.
So you mean you're in, like, the marijuana universe, and you're not going to even have a joint?
No, you know what? It's funny, because, you know, being in the film industry, everybody is smoking marijuana. I think I'm probably, like, one of the only ones that is sober when I'm working. You know, and it's just because, you know, that's just how I am when I'm working.
Well,
you
who
know,
wants to work sober?
Want
no one does that. I mean, me personally, I smoke weed so I can work longer, so I can make more money, so I can buy more weed. So I can work longer, so I can make more money, so I can buy more weed. You get the cycle? You got to join in.
You get the cycle.
I totally respect that. You know, but the people that I work with, oh my God, I see them, they don't even move after smoking. So I'm just like, dude, come on. Like, we got 12 hours. I don't want to be here for 24 hours. So,
what you do is you tell those people to DM me on Twitter and let's talk. You said 12 hours? You said 12 hours?
Jesus. Yeah, we do 12-hour days. That's sometimes not including rap time.
Yeah, that I understand why they're getting high. 12 hours? Shit. Only thing I can do for 12 hours. I won't say that on radio. Amy, you've been great.
Thank you guys for having me.
At underscore Israel. I-Z-R-E-A-L.
Okay.
I won't leave any marijuana post on your page. I promise.
Okay, what was it again? I-Z? Sorry, I got to put up my
I-Z. I-Z-R-E-A-L.
R-E-A-L.
You'll remember.
And I have a great pot smoking song that would go great for the soundtrack. Just saying.
Okay. All right. Yeah, I'll check it out.
Thank you.
That's a good one.
Well, thank you, Amy. Appreciate it. And let's do this. Let's play Yellow Bricks from Capella. When we come back, I am going to have a discussion. Me and Chris are going to have... We had a discussion while everybody was outside smoking, and he brought up a point, and I want him to say his point in front of all the rappers. So... that when we get back, hey. Yellow Bricks here on the world famous GJ Rightspear.
Gonna find you. Young nigga trying to make it to the big lights. Having good days trying to have a big night. Bars at the same effect like a real fight. Ain't about to lose, but I still might. Dawn the street light, yeah, I work harder. Cop the deal on you rappers, manslaughter. Gotta play it at the same level, both Carters. Life a bitch and I love her, God's daughter. Tryna make a dollar stretch like a rubber band. I ain't got the call yet and I don't understand. Yeah, they say I'm dope and I get a little hope. But it's no make a broke, nigga, bring the rope. Dream and a plan, bills in the other hand. Without the upper hand, skill still another fan. And it ain't nothing personal, it's promise, man. Burning bushes while we travel to the promised land. And in the meantime, I gotta feed mine. Niggas wanna call the shots, we need bond. Tryna keep calm, fearing the apocalypse. first letter S. This is my metropolis. Getting money easy is harder to get a compliment. One saying nothing, so I don't see what a problem is. Came a long way from cornbread and collard green, but I ain't about to be whatever side of the lane. Selling out can never be an option. I was born to greatness, and no, we can't adopt ya. Mina Rasta, buy me fitted like the ganja. Shit is at a stay, fuck you and your fucking plunger. Has me rolled to a club. I'm about to get a bunch of duck lips in a row. Got me cooking all day, got hits on the stove. Tell them hoes that I need about six on a pole. Still stand opposed when I'm fixing a blow. Me and music go together like tricks in a hoe. Stick to the flow if I slip it a show. Forever rapping for the yellow bricks on the road. They're writing all your verses and you still ain't lyrical. Music my religion, nigga, you just need a miracle. You actors ain't a factor, matter of fact, I leave you critical. Bitch, I die trying, hope they play that at your funeral. Ain't enough U-Hauls for the whole ghetto. Can't afford a fall short of a gold medal. Switching to bachelor mode, nigga, I won't settle. The pot of gold, gotta go with a gold kettle. Kinda lonesome when my mama says she got cancer. Guess it's one of the questions that he will not answer. Got a kid at the crib and he's so handsome. I'ma keep him hostage, I don't need a ransom. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide, yeah. Gonna find you and make you want me. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide, yeah. Gonna find you and take his life. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide, yeah. Gonna find you and make you want me. Ready or not, here I come. Yeah, gonna find you and take it
like
fast food and house. We need to also talk about not just the women, but
I said Burger King line.
Hey, this is Jim Cornette, the manager of the legendary Midnight Express and now the face of TNA Management, and you're listening to the Jiggy Jaguar on JiggyJaguar.com.
It is a world-famous Jiggy Jaguar experience, coast-to-coast, border-to-border, all over the world, wide web, over at JiggyJaguar.com, JiggyJaguar.net. Getting it in where we fit in.
Yo.
We got Capella in the building. Yep. Forget about what you've heard. Forget about Ferris and Jello fights. Capella in the building.
Yo, I'm feeling the track, bro.
We had a passerby in the Professor Steve Lovesy getting it in where he fits in, which, by the way, in certain cases, almost nowhere. We've got Jesus and Tylan in the building, along with Sammy and her. Along with Sammy, who was a rejected Wendy's...
Bug nasty.
She was a rejected Wendy's spokesmodel. She showed up. She showed up with that hair and about 60 pounds of metal in her face, and somebody ran out with a magnet and drug her around the parking lot. And...
Sammy's pissed. Blood guy.
Then we've got Jennifer. Of course, Jennifer has an entire song named after her. Let's go. Hood rat, random penis, cocaine, fuck you, blowjob room, 1, 2, 3, blowjob room, cupcakes. Now, Israel, explain the cupcakes to our good buddy Capella.
All right, me and my friend, we walked through the store. We've been friends since like second or third grade. And I said something crazy to him, and he says, "Shut up before I duct tape and butt rape your mom."
Damn.
This shit's funny to me because I'm inappropriate. So this old white lady, and we were by the duct tape, and that's kind of, you know, where it came from. But the old white lady, she turns red in the face and she walks out. So I told him, I was like, "Well, I'll duct tape and butt rape your mom, and if she's nice, I'll give her a cupcake. But if she's not nice, she doesn't get the cupcake." So that's where that comes from. So, Capella, if you're going to do any duct taping or raping,
the manager's over here scared shit.
I don't see that in my near future.
Time out. Time out, guys. I took up for Jennifer earlier because Jiggy kept calling her the resident hood rat. No. And during the show, she just bust out with birth control. Just in the middle of our show. She just bust out with a birth control pack. That's safe sex for your ass. Like, you know,
that's why we got a name. A song.
Yeah.
So I just had a song.
So, yeah, that you guys got to be careful because I read in the Bible that this one lady got pregnant and she didn't even have sex. So, you
was
definitely.
Was her name perhaps Mary?
Yeah, that's it.
Jane.
So, now, you got to be very careful. You got to be very careful.
Now, sometimes Israel.
I put on a random condom just because I don't want a Jesus baby. What? I can't afford that. I can't afford to have another. You know what I mean? Like, oh, Jesus got me pregnant. It's your baby. You can't deny Jesus' baby. So, that's more child support and I can't do it.
Now, you mentioned Hutchinson Fast Food earlier.
Hutchinson Fast Food. Let me tell you about it.
Hurry the fuck up.
They should just say Hutchinson Food because it's nothing fast about it. Now, there's like about, you know, 1,000 people in Hutchinson. And 600 seem to be Burger King. So, I go to Burger King and I order, you know, 2 cheeseburgers. And I'm there for like 10 minutes. Ooh. So, I finally get pissed off. And I drive, you know, across the street to Taco Bell, and I end up waiting another 2 minutes. Now, Taco Bell's a lot smarter than Burger King because where they're positioned, once you're in line, you can't get out. So, you're pretty much stuck. But enough about that. Let's get back to this track by Capella.
Yes.
I like the lyrics. Not only was he rapping on there, that was his singing, too, man. Great vocals. I like that. Sometimes you hear independent artists and don't go get your homegirl who say she's singing, she really can't, because it sounds horrible. I've heard it. And you're like, oh, my friend sings, she's going to do this hook for me. And she sounds like she's being sacrificed to Satan, you know, or something.
Like
I don't know.
Camel's
yeah, it's just horrible. like, all right, let me hear the hook. You know, the hook is what's supposed to draw people in. And she's like, we are hustling. You like, wow.
Man, I'm loving all these phrases y'all coming up with.
I've corrupted you, Capella.
Corrupted you, Capella.
Yeah, I've corrupted you. You've been affected. Your life will never be the same. Me and all of my 6 billion followers.
Well, speaking of being corrupted.
Yeah, what's wrong with the beer we got?
Now, we got Cousin Chris is in the building. And Cousin Chris and I, when everybody went out for a smoke break earlier,
yes,
we were having a discussion, I guess is what they call it. And he brought up XV. He brought up Verizon commercials. He brought up...
Shout out to Vizzy.
The hip-hop game, he was like, 316 stand up, I don't want to hear this. Because it's all about one person. And
it's
that's
you.
So
it's
go.
About you rapping.
Go.
Your music. It's about your music. He's not coming back to help you guys. He's done. He's like, going away.
Now,
all
let
right,
me.
No, no.
Hold on. Now.
No. It's about
one more time. I'm going to say this.
One person.
Shout out to XV. He's doing his thing. He says, Cousin Chris here just says that he's not helping anybody. He doesn't do anything. Blah, blah, blah. Right? Right here, I'm going to show you right here where I just talked to him on Facebook. I'm showing him on my phone. I just talked to the guy a week ago. You see, it's haters like him that keep us from getting anywhere. You follow what I'm saying? It's haters like that. Mm-hmm. Look, if this guy's doing this thing, why should he be in Wichita? I'm from Wichita. I love it. But it's so small, it's only so much you can do. I love that he's out doing this thing and he's bringing more light to the city. There's a phrase that says, proper preparation prevents poor performance. So what that says to me, hater ass Chris, that's your new name. His new name is Hack. Hater ass Chris. So when you hear me say Hack, you know what I'm talking about. But seriously, there are some people, there are some artists in Wichita who should relinquish the microphone and leave it to
Mike Game. God damn, I got that call.
Mike Game, look, I'm not in your beef with Jiggy. I'm not in your beef with Jiggy. That's between y'all.
Oh, now.
I support all our artists. Like I said, it's not for me to judge.
Black and Mild. No, go ahead.
Back to what Pat said.
hating ass Chris over here. We can't let.
I'm not on camera, so no one can prove I said it. Go ahead.
We can't let, you know what I mean, people like Chris stop our movement. We got a lot of momentum going. It's a lot of good things that's happened in the city. And just like any other market, it takes time to develop. You know what I mean? It takes time to mature. And as long as we have artists like myself, like Capella, like Essie. And speaking of Essie, I went to the gas station this week. And I met this artist from Kansas City. We swapped discs. I'm playing the disc. I go through a couple songs. The first thing I hear is, this is an Essie Trill production. I was ecstatic about it because he's from my city. Uh-huh. We go interview Tech N9ne and Strange Music. I'm talking to Stevie Song. We're talking about his new album, which you should go get, Two Birds, One Stone. Shout out to Stevie. And guess who did a track on the CD?
Essie Trill.
And who else? Big Cliff. These dudes are, we're expanding. You know what I mean? We're moving out and we're building. And part of our motivation is
Chris doesn't believe a word of it. You can just tell on his face.
Chris hates everybody.
Chris, his problem is, what you guys don't know is, he used to rap. Yeah, he was in a group. It. He was in a group called Thugs and Suds. Yeah, they had this whole album where they were in the bathtub with 12 gauges and gun belts. Mm-hmm. It was him and another boy, and it was Bubbles, and it was steamy.
Wait. I'm gonna get buried for this, but he already doesn't like me. I was gonna say, how did the Hitman end up in this group? But go ahead.
Thugs.
He already doesn't like me, so give him another reason.
Thugs and Sons. So that's where we're at, and that's why Chris is so mad. Uh-huh. But man, to all the artists in Wichita, man, if you're doing your thing, we support you. Our time is coming. You know, just do your best. You don't have to do everything.
Look at Chris's face.
You don't have to do everything.
If you're watching this on Ustream, it's hilarious.
Help me out here.
Now, I'm going to say this. Actually, Chris got a point a little bit. We do have a lot of artists, and when they do say 316 up or 316 stand up, it's just about the record that they're putting out, and they want the 316 movement behind it.
Yeah.
Now, I will rest to that fact. I will say that, yeah, that does happen. However, there's other artists like myself, like I'm sure Israel does.
Yeah.
I mean, we don't just say it. If you go to my page right now, you'll probably see 2-3 different artists, videos or songs or something
it's
like
that.
Right,
it's not mine that I
from
share.
From 316. I don't just say it. I mean it, you know, like, because I know we ain't going nowhere without that kind of unity. We're not going nowhere without the city behind us.
Exactly.
Like, you go out anywhere, if you ever try to market your music outside of the city, the first thing they ask you is, well, how's your city responding to you?
Yeah.
You know, so you have to have that. You have to have that locked down before you even do anything else. And I'm trying. I'm sure Israel is.
Yeah.
I'm sure there's a lot of people back home that's doing it right now, but until we all get to that point and say, like, you know what, we all gonna support each other, because if we don't eat, like, if we don't starve together, then we won't eat together. And then if one person makes it out and then don't come back or is doing his own thing there, can you really blame him?
I'll be honest with you, man. You know, I do whatever I can to help any artist, because the people in Wichita, they're not my competition. We're not each other's competition.
True.
It's whoever's on the top of the Billboard charts, which I look at every freaking week.
Always a competition.
That's who's my competition. Mm-hmm. I'll be honest with you, flat out, you heard it here from Israel out your own mouth on KJAG Radio. If you are an artist from Wichita and you're not supporting other artists, fuck you. Bottom line. If you're not supporting our movement, if you're not supporting other artists, then I don't fool with you. Now, if I see that you're on Facebook and you're doing shows with other people and whatever else, man, I love it. Any artist who wants to collab with me, I've told them. I would never charge you. Let's just get it. Let's just do it. You know what I mean? But it's haters like Chris that fuels us. That, you know what I mean? That fuels us. That gives us, you know what I mean, the opportunity to it drives me. Late at night, I'm at home, I'm writing diss songs, I see Chris's face. You know what I mean? And
it feels the more shit effect.
And then I throw up in my mouth a little bit.
You better get high more then.
Hey, before we go, we got a couple minutes left. And I want to send out a big thank you again to the Cotillion for hosting us Friday. I want to send a special thank you to Chris Calico, Tech N9ne, Mayday, Cess Crew, and Prozac. Those guys are great, man. They did a spot for the spot that we do on KJAC Radio, which is Step Your Game Up. And for that, for those that don't know, that's a segment that I do where I ask other artists, independent artists, about tips on how to step your game up in the music industry. You got to check it out. These guys are professional. They tour 398 days a year, so you know they know what they're talking about. You know what I mean? So we got to support each other. We need more unity. Make sure you go follow my boy Capella right now. Follow his manager, Shauna Hutchins. She's on Facebook under that name. Spell it out for us. And
S-H-A-N-N-A-H-U-T-C-H-E-N-S, Hutchins.
Yeah, hit her up. You can also find her on my friend list if you're one of my friends for any booking you might want to do with this guy. We're going to have some new music coming soon here. He's a great MC. I like it.
You know, mention the mention the music where we're wanting people to send music and everything.
Yes, yes, yes. Also, in 2 weeks, we're going to start playing a lot more music. We've been doing a lot of work with a lot of local businesses, and what they're going to do is actually be sponsoring artists to play their music on our shows. In response, we'll team you up with the business. You promote them, they'll promote you. It's great for everybody. It's a way to bring in more revenue for you and to just, you know, the grassroots effort. We want people to support us, but we don't ever want to support anybody else. In any undertaking that you're doing, man, you have to support other people. That's the only way it works. So KJAC Radio, man, we're going to be doing a lot of things. We're going to be helping you independent artists step your game up. We'll be playing music. We'll be interviewing. We'll be doing live remotes out for shows. We'll get Capella's manager in here. She'll give you guys some tips, too, on, you know, how to step your game up in booking. If you want to book him, man, do it. You know what I mean? Let's put these shows together. I know a lot of you guys got to be tired like I am of these B-rate, C-rate artists whose career is going to funk, coming to our city and getting our money, and we don't even get paid for the shows. Fuck that. Show some unity.
Tone Loke.
You know what
Coolio.
I mean?
Coolio.
Come on, man. Some of these guys. I'm not going to call nobody out in particular.
Color me bad.
Some of the guys that come to our town and get money, take our money away from our community and leave with it, are garbage.
Bubba Sparks.
You know what I mean? And it's time that we really get some unity and we really start supporting each other and stop being critical, so critical of each other. And I like to thank everybody on the show today, Capella, for coming through.
Thank you.
I'm glad to have you back. Make sure you go follow him on Twitter. Follow me at @_Israel. Don't follow hater ass Chris.
He has a Twitter account, but he never uses it.
I'm going to hack him.
Because he's a hater.
Nobody cares about Twitter, according to Chris. Now, of course, KJAC Radio, as Tom Smalling from formerly of Beneath the Burning Sun, now Victims of Spotlight, has said, KJAC Radio, we are drama-free, because I don't like drama.
No. You put your dress on, you run right towards like a white person in a gunfight.
Matter of fact.
You better go fucking check that shit out.
Speaking of drama, shout out to your YBD, your boy Drama. You know, Kansas. He gets it in whenever you finish. You know what I'm saying? And when I say 316 up, I mean it. Make sure you go out to the flea market and holler at my boy Rob Wonder. Make sure you also go to 813 South Woodline in Wichita, Kansas. Chops Barbershop. You know, holler at my boy Quincy. Tell him Israel sent you. And if you're out at the State Fair, make sure you go see Mr. Ed's Flagpole Company. They showed me a lot of love when I was out there. They got all kind of flags, NASCAR, because they support racists, KU, K-State, and they're out there doing it. The State Fair is good. Make sure you go out there. I just talked to Capella. He's going to be at the State Fair out there doing his promotion.
So
make sure you run up on him and pay him $100 a CD, something like that. You know what I mean? Follow him. I might be out there later. You know, I don't know if they're
he's gonna pull some Roger Cornish shit and hang out with the KWCH folks. And
I would be looking.
Hey,
for
shout
some
out
pimps.
To KWCH. You know what I'm saying, you know, I know people everywhere. my homegirl Emily Deaver Storm. Now she just recently got married. Her and Chris and Storm. Congratulations! I wish you guys a beautiful marriage. Jesus. And yeah.
That's I love it.
That's what I'm trying to get Chris to see. This isn't something that I just do. This is a lifestyle for me. You know what I mean? I'm about this life, son.
about this life, son.
I got 28 followers now. I know it. Woo, I feel 28. It. 28.
Okay, so before we leave, Chris, did they satisfy your argument, or are you still?
I guess whatever.
Don't tell me
nothing. Chris's inner child is Howie Mandel.
Well, hey, before we leave, Capella, anything big coming up? Anything we need to promote or whatever here?
Oh yeah, actually, before we forget, September 21st, that's the Who's Who party. It's gonna have a lot of people there. We've been talking about SC Trill, Cash Hollister, Carla Yala, Sarah.
Yeah, then
Myers.
I won't be allowed in the building.
Devin Bray is gonna be there. Hosted by Stone. Ray. Shout out to Phenom Radio too. They support local artists a lot. Yeah, my boy Slay Stone, DJ King Sway, United. DJ 316 up, Chris, in your face,
son.
Right,
everybody.
316 up in your face, son.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be at the Spotlight, too. And it's going to be big, man. Everybody come out. Your boy will be on stage. So,
yeah,
come
second
check
annual
it out.
One.
Yep. Funny because I was at the first one, but you know, I ain't getting no interviews or nothing. But man, the second one. That tells you how much work we done been putting in.
Yeah, definitely.
We on stage this time. So.
Well, Israel will, I'm hoping, be in the building for this.
I'm going to cover it for KJ.
And we'll have Mr. Swank or Mr. Ortiz or somebody in the building. We might send Juice out there.
We want Juice.
We got a new photographer named Juice in the building. Mm-hmm. And it's not OJ because he's still serving time. But we got to get it in. We fit in next week. It is going to be, I've got the two hip-hop artists on screen on Ustream because I want to see their reactions when I announce who we're having on next week. Jaxter will be here next week. He's the hottest thing in the business.
Cut it out.
What?
You know who
Hater
Jax
ass.
Is,
I don't know who the Jax is. He's got a fucking post on his wall.
He will murder you if he heard you say that.
That's right.
Well, he went to prison.
Same time next week.
It's a world famous Cheeky Jaguar show. We are going to leave you with Capella and Yellow Bricks here on the big broadcast.
Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide that.
Oh, Chris.
Young nigga trying to make it to the big lights. Having good days, trying to have a big night. Bars at the same effect like a real fight. I ain't about to lose, but I still might. Dawn the street light, yeah, I work harder. Cop the deal on you rappers, manslaughter. Gotta play it at the same level, both Carters. Life a bitch and I love her, God's daughter. Trying to make a dollar stretch like a rubber band. I ain't got the call yet and I don't understand. Yeah, they say I'm dope and I get a little hope. But it's no make a broke nigga, bring the rope. Dream and a plan, bills in the other hand. Without the upper hand, scale still another fan. It ain't nothing personal, it's comments, man. Burning bushes while we travel to the promised land. And in the meantime, I gotta feed mine. Niggas wanna call the shots, we need bombs. Tryna keep calm, fearing the apocalypse. First letter S, this is my metropolis. Getting money easy, it's harder to get a compliment. Weren't saying nothing, so I don't see what the problem is. Came a long way from cornbread and collard greens. But I ain't about to be whatever side of dollar lane. Selling out can never be an option. I was born to greatness, and no, we can't adopt ya. Mina Rasta, buy me fitting like the ganja. Shit is at a stake, fuck you and your fucking plunger. As we roll to a close, I'm about to get a bunch of duck lips in a row. Got me cooking all day, got hits on the stove. Tell them hoes that I need about six on a pole. Still stand opposed when I'm fixing a blow. Me and music go together like tricks in a hoe. Stick to the flow if I slip it a show. Forever rapping for the yellow bricks on the road. They're writing all your verses and you still ain't lyrical. Music my religion, nigga, you just need a miracle. You actors ain't a factor, matter of fact, I leave you critical. Rich or die trying, hope they played it at your funeral. Ain't enough U-Hauls for the whole ghetto. Can't afford to fall short of a gold medal. Switching to bachelor mode, nigga, I won't settle. The pot of gold, gotta go with a gold kettle. kinda lost it when my mama said she got cancer. Guess it's one of the questions that he will not answer. Got a kid at the crib and he's so handsome. I'ma keep him hostage, I don't need a ransom.
Ready or not, here I come, you can't hide, yay. Gonna find you and make you want me. Ready or not, here I come, you can't hide, yay. Gonna find you and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come, you can't hide, yay. Gonna find you and make you want me. Ready or not, here I come, you can't hide, yay.
This is Jim Cornette, the manager of the legendary Midnight Express and now the face of TNA Management, and you're listening to the Jiggy Jaguar on JiggyJaguar.com.
nigga tryna make it to the big lights. Having good days, tryna have a big night. Bars at the same effect like a real fight. Ain't about to lose, but I still might. Dawn the street light, yeah I work harder. Cop the deal on you rappers, manslaughter. Gotta play it at the same level, both Carters. Life a bitch and I love her, God's daughter. Tryna make a dollar stretch like a rubber band. I ain't got the call yet and I don't understand. Yeah, they say I'm dope and I get a little hope. But it's no make a broke, nigga, bring the rope. Dream and a plan, bills in the other hand. Without the upper hand, skill still another fan. And it ain't nothing personal, it's comments, man. Burning bushes while we travel to the promised land. And in the meantime, I gotta feed mine. Niggas wanna call the shots, we need bombs. Tryna keep calm, fearing the apocalypse. First letter S, this is my metropolis. Getting money easy, it's harder to get a compliment. Weren't saying nothing, so I don't see what the problem is. Came a long way from cornbread and collard greens. But I ain't about to be whatever side of dollar lane. Selling out can never be an option. I was born to greatness and no, we can't adopt ya. Me na rasta, by me fit it like the ganja. Shit is here to stay, fuck you when you fucking plunger. As we roll to a close, I'm about to get a bunch of duck lips in a row. Got me cooking all day, got hits on the stove. Tell them hoes that I need about six on a pole. Still stand opposed when I'm fixing a blow. Me and music go together like tricks in a hoe. Stick to the flow if I slip it a show. Forever rapping for the yellow bricks on the road. They're writing all your verses and you still ain't lyrical. Music my religion, nigga, you just need a miracle. You actors ain't a factor, matter of fact, I leave you critical. Rich or die trying, hope they play that at your funeral. Ain't enough U-Hauls for the whole ghetto. Can't afford to fall short of a gold medal. Switching to bachelor mode, nigga, I won't settle. The pot of gold, gotta go with a gold kettle. Kinda lost it when my mama said she got cancer. Guess it's one of the questions that he will not answer. Got a kid at the crib and he's so handsome. I'ma keep him hostage, I don't need a ransom.
Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide, yeah. Gonna find you and make you want me. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide, yeah. Gonna find you and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide, yeah. Gonna find you and make you want me. Ready or not, here I come. Yeah, gonna find you and take it
This is Jim Cornette, the manager of the legendary Midnight Express and now the face of TNA Management, and you're listening to the Jiggy Jaguar on JiggyJaguar.com.
nigga trying to make it to the big lights. Having good days, trying to have a big night. Bars at the same effect like a real fight. Ain't about to lose, but I still might. Don the street light, yeah, I work harder. Cop the deal on you rappers, manslaughter. Gotta play it at the same level, both Carters. Life a bitch and I love her, God's daughter. Trying to make a dollar stretch like a rubber band. I ain't got the call yet and I don't understand. Yeah, they say I'm dope and I get a little hope. But it's no make a broke nigga, bring the rope. Dream and a plan, bills in the other hand. Without the upper hand, scale still another fan. And it ain't nothing personal, it's comments, man. Burning bushes while we travel to the promised land. And in the meantime, I gotta feed mine. Niggas wanna call the shots, we need bombs. Tryna keep calm, fearing the apocalypse. First letter S, this is my metropolis. Getting money easy, it's harder to get a compliment. Weren't saying nothing, so I don't see what the problem is. Came a long way from cornbread and collard greens. But I ain't about to be whatever side of dollar lane. Selling out can never be an option. I was born to greatness and no, we can't adopt ya. Mina Rasta, by me feeling like the ganja. Shit is at a state, fuck you and your fucking plunger. As we roll to a close, I'm about to get a bunch of duck lips in a row. I've been cooking all day, got hits on the stove. Tell them hoes that I need about six on a pole. Still stand opposed when I'm fixing a blow. Me and music go together like tricks in a hoe. Stick to the flow if I slip at a show. Forever rapping for the yellow bricks on the road. They're writing all your verses and you still ain't lyrical. Music my religion, nigga, you just need a miracle. You actors ain't a factor, matter of fact, I leave you critical. Rich or die trying, hope they play that at your funeral. Ain't enough U-Hauls for the whole ghetto. Can't afford to fall short of a gold medal. Switching to bachelor mode, nigga, I won't settle. The pot of gold, gotta go with a gold kettle. Kinda lost it when my mama said she got cancer. Guess it's one of the questions that he will not answer. Got a kid at the crib and he's so handsome. I'ma keep him hostage, I don't need.
oh, my friend sings, she's gonna do this hook for me, and she sound like she's being sacrificed to Satan. You know, or something. I don't know. Yeah, it's just horrible. like, all right, let me hear the hook. You know, the hook is what's supposed to draw people in, and she's like, we are here hustling. You like,
say Matt Chris is the king.
These worldwide competitions are best experienced live. Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 global sporting events to attend before you die. For this list, we've chosen 10 of the most iconic and popular sporting events from around the world and ranked them based on their impact, recognition, and spectator friendliness.
Jones hits the ship. Jones to the end zone, and he's in for the score. What a play by Jacoby Jones.
Number 10, the Tour de France. Though its reputation's been slightly tainted by Lance Armstrong's doping scandal, the Tour de France remains one of the world's biggest and most popular sporting events. Every summer, this multiple-stage bicycle race has its male elite road cyclists trying to beat the clock over an exhausting 23 days. Simply put, it's nothing short of thrilling to watch 200 riders compete for that yellow jersey among breathtaking French mountain scenery. Number 9, the Rugby World Cup. Every 4 years, this tournament brings together the world's top rugby teams in one of the planet's largest sporting events. Though billions watch the event on TV, that just doesn't cut it. With athletes as passionate and enthusiastic as the fans, there's little that'll compare to getting up close and personal with your favorite team, especially if they're bringing home the coveted William Webb Ellis Cup. Number 8, the Ryder Cup. Officially the Ryder Cup